Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
I'm Brian Mix, and I will be the first presenter of the Quinton County Group, and our topic is obesity. And we'll be discussing a rising trend in America today, not just in America, but around the world. So, what is obesity? Obesity is a rising problem in our country, particularly the southern states. We tend to have a lot of problems in this area. But basically, I'll start off by saying what obesity is and what it is considered as from a medical condition. It is considered a medical condition in which the body has acquired too much, or excess body fat, I'll say. Know that some body fat is good, is actually healthy for the body, but when you get to the point where you're in excess, then that's when it becomes a major health issue for you. And it can also lead to other problems as well, but on down the line. But basically, it's defined according to the National Institute of Health. Obesity is defined as having a body mass index of 30 or greater. No matter your height, there's a BMI scale, so anything 30 or greater is defined as being obese. Many of the southern states in the United States have some of the highest rates of obesity in the country. According to recent data released in September of 2015, Mississippi is the third leading state in adult obesity, with rates exceeding greater than 35%. I believe number one was Arkansas, and I think number two was, I want to say Tennessee, I believe. But Mississippi is third leading state in obesity. And to make matters worse, I would say Mississippi is the leading state in childhood obesity. So this problem is apparently starting in the early age. And this is something we have to take hold of and try to do something about. As I mentioned earlier, obesity can have serious and sometimes fatal effects on one's overall health. It can lead to heart problems, kidney problems, liver failure, things like that. Adults and children who are obese are at increased risk for high blood pressure, heart disease, and in particular diabetes. Of the three, diabetes is more prominent than the other two. The rates of diabetes can exceed like 41%, which is pretty high. So obese, like I said, causes most of these problems, but diabetes is number one. So we have to take a hold of this, especially, like I said, starting in our early ages with our children. According to the CDC, Center for Disease Control, adults, more than 37.7% of adults were obese, and these numbers were taken back in 2014, and more than one-third of the children, and this is the entire country as a whole, were obese. So more than one-third of our country's children are overweight. Next, we'll go to causes of obesity.
If she can't, I will.
Okay, so next we'll discuss some of the causes of obesity. Just some of the general causes, you know, sedentary lifestyle, not enough movement throughout the day. Particularly our diet, what we eat, what we put in our body, and what we do to take it off whatever we put in. A lot of times, you know, we tend to eat late at night, especially in the nursing field. We know this, especially we tend to eat late at night, and a lot of times what we do, eat, lay down, maybe watch TV a little bit, go straight to sleep. So that's one of the leading problems, or causes rather, of obesity, especially with adults. In the case of children, I say a lot of times still eating the wrong foods, not enough outdoor activity. I think they're recommending now where children have at least 60 minutes a day of exercise and play, things like that. So a lot of that's important because they're outside running around and doing what they do, but a lot of times they're getting a lot of exercise with that as well. But we look at our slide here, so real quick, some of the causes of obesity, lack of energy balance, like I was saying, a lot of times we're putting in the wrong things and not doing enough to get those things out of our system. Balance over time is what maintains a healthy weight. So we have to balance all of these things over time. I'm not saying that we can't, you know, enjoy an occasional burger or fry, things like that, but it's all about all in moderation, right? So we have to, you know, kind of maintain this over a certain period of time and make sure we're not eating too much of the wrong foods and not enough of the right foods. Causes of obesity, can anybody see this? It's a little dark, okay. Like I said, same reasons for inactive lifestyle. A lot of times we spend too much time in front of the TV, relying on cars rather than walking, lack of physical education classes in school for children, fewer physical demands at work or home due to technology convenience. We all have iPhones, iPads, things like that. So a lot of these things tend to make life a lot easier for us, which we do enjoy. But it's still just, it's always important to get outside and then exercise and do, you know, do it the old fashioned way. Some more reasons for inactive lifestyle. Too much time in front of the TV is a big one. It's a major fact. A lot of times we're spending too much time sitting down, not enough time up and moving around and doing things that will help us, you know, burn off some of the calories that we take in when we eat too much of the wrong things. You know, our environment also plays a role in how obese we are as a whole, as a nation. Lack of sidewalks and safe places for recreation, activities like, you know, reporting gym and things like that. Oversized food portions, you know, like I said, everything in moderation, right? So you want to make sure you're not eating too much of the wrong things. Food advertising on TV, McDonald's, Burger King, KFC, Popeyes, we see all those commercials every day, and everything looks good to us. So we kind of got to watch it. And it all leads back, like I said, too much time in front of the TV. It also comes from family history. Genetics can also play a role in how obese we are. Health conditions such as hormone problems, hypothyroidism, Cushing syndrome, medications such as antidepressants and steroids can make us gain weight. And stress, you know, a lot of times with bored or anger can also, emotions and hormones play a big role in that as well. Real quick, smoking. Lack of nicotine with smoking cessation slows the rate at which your body burns calories. Of course, pregnancy, you know, it's a way to gain healthy weight during pregnancy, but a lot of times during pregnancy, women can tend to overeat. So I want to make sure we're watching our weight during pregnancy as well. It's very important. And as well, lack of sleep.
Hi, I'm Kateri Evans. I'm here to prevent ways to prevent obesity. One of the best ways to prevent obesity is prevention. You can incorporate daily prevention habits in your daily routines. Let's look at a few. Making healthy eating choices. It's a simple decision to just replace different foods and make a better eating choice every day. Moderation is key. When it comes to consuming foods, pay attention to serving sizes and ensure appropriate calorie intake. You can use your hand as an example. You should have 2 to 3 servings of meat, protein, dairy. So the palm of your hand, you can measure your meat, which should be 3 ounces in 1 serving. You can use your thumb to measure a tablespoon. The tip of your finger as a teaspoon. The front of your clenched fist could be seen as a half a cup, and your fist holding meat this way could be seen as 1 cup. That's the easy way to measure your serving size. Limit high sugar snacks and drinks. Eating only when hungry reduces calorie intake and mindless snacking. Eating slowly allows you to feel fuller faster. Choose to make home cooked meal of fast food. Bake, grill, or boil your foods instead of frying. Choose low fat and fat-free snacks instead of chips and cookies. You should have 5 to 9 servings of fruits and vegetables daily. Increase water intake. You should have 6 to 8 glasses of water a day. Choose whole grain foods and avoid eating processed foods. And eat breakfast. That's the best way to start your day. Be active is another way to help prevent obesity. Become involved in 30 to 45 minutes of physical activity at least 3 times a week. Reduce TV time and computer time and replace it with outdoor time, especially with kids. They love their tablets and be playing on mother's phone. You can get them outside and run around. That's a good way for them to burn calories. Get involved in outdoor activities such as gardening and sports. This is something mom can take part in instead. Take the stairs instead of the elevator. At work, you can take the stairs instead of the elevator. It helps burn calories. Make a daily step goal. You can use, everyone has a smartphone, so you have a health app on there, most smartphones do. And you can set a goal every day. My goal is 6,000 steps a day, and that's 3 miles. So you can use your phone, keep it on you as you walk every day instead of daily step goal. That'll help you burn calories. And each week, increase that goal. Monitor your weight regularly. Identify triggers. Become aware of situations that may cause you to eat excessively. As Brian stated earlier, eating when you're sad, depressed, or just sitting down because you have nothing else to do. Just get out and do something because they can cause you to eat more than you want to. Once triggers are identified, plan ahead and develop secondary outlets to eating. Create a strategy such as journaling to express feelings and monitor your food intake and control heavy form activities that will eventually help become them drink someone. Yep. Be consistent with exercising and be consistent with watching what you eat.
And I will be discussing dietary habits in relation to obesity. Obesity is a growing problem, not just in the community, but in America. The Center for Disease Control estimates that about 68% of Americans are overweight. Dietary habits play an essential part in weight gain, which leads to obesity. Poor dietary habits are contributed to traditions and the need for fast access to foods. Let me elaborate on that. Oftentimes, we learn poor eating habits from our own parents, and we pass it along into adulthood and along to our own children. Due to the rise in economic costs, there is an increased rate in the amount of working families, which results in lesser time spent at home and lesser home-cooked meals. And we're resorting to eating out at least 3 to 4 times a week. Most fast foods are high in fats, high in sodium, and high in calories. And even some restaurants offer a larger portion of food, which is not the recommended serving size. WebMD, which is an online website, have 10 bad habits that lead to weight gain. And I would like to share some with you. Eating amnesia, not paying attention to the amount of food that you consume. Starvation mode, waiting until you are excessively hungry to eat. Getting less sleep / after-night snacking. Studies suggest that there's a hormone that produces cortisol, that produces a sensation of hunger when you get less amount of sleep, and thus you eat late at night, and you also store more fats. Skipping breakfast. Everyone has heard the saying that breakfast is the most important meal of the day, and that is true because it jumpstarts our metabolism and our energy that we need for that day. Some people want to eat healthy, but they just don't know how. They have questions like what to eat, how often to eat, and how much to eat, which leads me into my next slide, dietary recommendations. The general calorie recommended per day is about 1,500 to 1,800 calories per day. But it depends upon your age, your gender, and your physical activity level. The rule of thumb is the more calories you consume equals the more weight gain. If you consume about the same amount of calories per day, you're maintaining that stable weight. And you consume lesser amount of calories, that's when you would see weight loss. But again, it is depending upon how physically active are. Up on this projector is an illustration of a food pyramid. The food pyramid serves as a guideline to the amount of nutrients and calories needed per day for to maintain a healthy weight. It was developed with facts in mind because the researchers noticed that Americans have a tendency to eat high fat foods. So for those who don't know how much to eat, the food pyramid shows you serving size per food groups that you can consume. Some good food choices, and I chose these because they are tend to be produce a sensation of fullness quicker, which results in lesser calories, so, such as vegetables, whole fruits, nuts, seeds, beans, cooking in olive oil or canola oil, and whole grain products. Dietary recommendation for energy sources from carbohydrates, fats, and proteins. I will elaborate upon the fats because that's what we're talking about with dietary and obesity. You should have no more than about 35% of your energy source coming from fats, which is about 400 calories per day. So, a lot of times we go out to eat and we're not aware of how much calories is in just a portion of food. One slice of meat lover's pizza has about 540 calories, with 230 of those calories coming from fats. A Big Mac is, again, 540 calories, with about 250 of those calories coming from fats. Remember I said you should have no more than about 400. So if you're eating a Big Mac and a slice of pizza, you got your amount that you can get of fats. Lastly, I wanted to leave you guys with some tips for eating out. Leave off the sauces. For those of us who like mayonnaise on everything, if you do, you know, try to get a low-fat mayonnaise or substitute the mayonnaise for mustard. Substitute the fries. Most of the time, there is an option to get a vegetable or a fruit, so try to do that. Limit portions. When you're at a restaurant and you order your food and the waitress brings it, cut your food into halves. Ask for a to-go container. Place half of your food into a to-go container and only eat what's left on that plate before you, okay? And lastly, get it grilled instead of fried. Most of the times there is an option, so choose grilled, okay?
I'm Linda Payne on part of the equipment group, and our objectives are for this study is to decrease the risk of obesity and educate the community regarding illnesses related to obesity. The importance of exercise. Regular exercise and proper nutrition can reduce body fat as well as protect against chronic diseases associated with obesity, such as high blood pressure, type 2 diabetes, high cholesterol, osteoporosis, and certain cancers. For obese persons, the focus of exercise programs should be based on low intensity aerobic exercise, nothing too strenuous to start out on. And the aerobic exercises will give you an overall general output of your health benefits. It includes losing weight, includes daily energy, and reduced risk of health problems. And exercise, and the aim for exercise is to exercise 4 or 5 days a week for at least 30 to 60 minutes. If you have a sedentary lifestyle, you just cannot jump in there. You have to work yourself up to it. So that may mean you start out with 3 minutes a day with a gradual increase. Exercise. Regular exercise and physical activity can also make you feel better. It helps your bones, your muscles, and your joints. It reduces anxiety, stress, depression, and boosts your mood. It helps control weight, and it decreases joint swelling and pain from arthritis. It helps you feel more energetic, helps you sleep better, and improves your overall output of yourself, how you feel about yourself, your self-esteem. When you look good, you feel good. That's the old statement. Mm-hmm. Exercise. Have fun and be healthy. Just lose weight. Exercise technique. Engage in activity that puts minimal stress on the joints, such as walking, swimming, or water exercise, and cycling. Ease into your workout. Start for the first time 5 minutes to give your body time to adjust to the activity. Work at a comfortable pace for yourself. Don't compete. Work at a comfortable pace that works for you, that allows you to talk without difficult breathing. Focus on increasing duration first, then increasing intensity. At the end of your exercise, don't just sit down, don't just go to the same pace. You slow down for 5 minutes in your last exercise session so your body can come back to its resting state. Remember, finish with stretching every time you exercise. Do you have any questions for us? Thank you for your time. Thank you for your participation with the equipment.